Welcome back to the second tutorial of ColdFusion. Today I want to look into basic programming logic, and for that I have of course a presentation. We're going back to school. Do you remember these flow diagrams you had maybe to work with at school? I at least used a couple of them. We had to understand logic of if this is right, then this will happen, and if not, it goes back to start. Or, well, think of a washing machine, for example. At first, it checks if there's any water is connected, and if the water is connected, it will take some water, and then it will pick up water, it will pick up the powder, and it will run a couple of times. After the washing has been wetted, it will add the soap to it, and then when that is added, it will tumble even more, and tumble, tumble, tumble left, and then tumble, tumble right. I don't know. Was this a silly example, really? Anyway, if you don't remember, we will go through them. Here, for example, you have a student and a registration system, and a question or logic question called is the student registered, and a classroom. So a student comes to the school, and there's this system that is checking, is the student registered? If the student is not registered, the student needs to be registered in the registration system, and then the process starts again at the start at student. And then it will check again, is the student registered? And then, yes, then it will be sent to classroom. And that's what we see here. So here you have the student. Is the student registered? No. Registration. Back there. Is student registered? Now, yes. Sent to classroom. This is stuff that you'll also find everywhere online. Everywhere logic. Computers, your phone will do it. Anything, and websites just as well. So let's take a very worldly example of login on Twitter, any login anyway, but login on Twitter. So you login on the Twitter page, right? You have a page, you type in or on your phone, of course, the same. You log in with your username, your email address, or your username, and then password. And then you click on the login button, and then you send the form, or all the information on the form, you send it to the Twitter server, web server. There we have the Twitter web server. And the Twitter web server has to then have logic, and usually a database, and check in the logic, and then make a login. So here we see the login page, where on the left side, where you have filled in data. I've forgotten an arrow here, but that it goes here to the web server. We're looking in the web server anyway now. So there's logic. Does the username exist? So it will first check if the username exists. If the username doesn't exist, then it will already send an error back to the page. Sorry, the username does not exist. And if the username exists, then it goes further to the next step. Logic, is the password correct? So now it goes and check if the password is correct for this username that exists in the server. If it exists, it will log you in and generate the Twitter homepage HTML, and it will send it back to the login page. If it's wrong, once again, it will send an error. What kind of error? That is another story. I mean, you can say, hey, the username doesn't exist. Hey, the password was incorrect. In most cases nowadays, websites just say the login was incorrect, because else user hackers will very clearly know, okay, the username doesn't exist, I have to look in different email usernames. Or if the password doesn't exist, then they very know very well that the username also exists, and that they will have to just go and send up thousands and thousands upon new passwords, possibly one is correct, right? So that is why websites nowadays say, sorry, but the login is not correct. Anyway, that aside, let's do this in ColdFusion, right? Let's do this in ColdFusion. In ColdFusion, we ask questions with the CFIF tag. If the username is correct, you go to the next question. If the password is correct, that is the next question, right? Create Twitter main page for the user and send the Twitter main page HTML to the user. And if the password is incorrect, then we send an error. And if the username is incorrect, also send an error. As you can see, the order of things is a little bit different than the flow diagram has got. Because you have first the username is correct, and then it goes within this if statement, another question, if the password is correct. Then it does stuff, and then it will say, and then it will look for the opposite of this one, which is the incorrect, to send an error. And after that one is closed, because you actually have the closed tags as well, you can also check for the incorrect value of the username and send an error. So here you have the ColdFusion version of it. Well, kinda, right? I still use some variable names here. Send username being the username that we sent to the server, and var username the username that we are checking on. This would normally be a database field somewhere, right? But now for the ease of use, I use var username for where I store my usernames, and var password for the password to check. So if send username is var username, that will say will basically means is like that what we have sent is that the same as the username that we have stored. So basically underneath here it has to be true. So now we're gonna check another statement if the password is right, because then is the username correct and the password is right. So send password equals var password. So if that one is correct, we are now logged in and this is your Twitter main page. So now basically we could generate the feed, the Twitter feed here, and that would be visible to, because this is what the server then sends back to the browser, and then you will be able to see this page. I put an abort here. This is a tag to stop from processing further. CF else. This is basically the opposite of the true statement. This will make it like it's if it's a true statement. So the opposite if is this else. You can also, there has an else if, and you can make even more questions, even more things to true states to check for. But see if else is just anything else. So if the password isn't correct, we will display error, login incorrect. We can send the user back to the login page. So I could send here some logic that it sends back to the login page. And then it ends this see if if statement. So the send password check is stopped here. And then we have still this one open, the if send username part. So here, this else statement is for if the username is not the same. And you will see error, username is incorrect. We can send the user back to the login page for this as well. And then slash, this is my presentation software, slash CFIF to stop the if statement. So let's do this for real now. We will build a page just like that. Just a quick thing. I didn't make any colors, but I made the page look a little bit better now. This is also the main page. This is like smallbrainergames.com/ColdFusion tutorials. This will give you all the lessons in the future. Right now only two lessons, one from last week and now from this week, lesson 2. So let's click on that one. Oh. I think I didn't update that one yet. Well, apparently I made two copies of lesson and the link wrong. Lesson 2 it is, yeah. Not lesson 1. So I made a link wrong. So lesson 2, it should not be purple, I should have seen that, because the purple means that it has been visited. Lesson 2 we haven't been yet. Lesson 2, logic with CFIF logic functionality. This is lesson 2, if logic. Welcome to lesson 2. Part 1 of Lesson 2 is to explain you how logic is working in the real world of both flow diagrams and a real life example, which is this Twitter example that we started on, and then I showed you how this works with if statements. In Part 2 we will look at variables and if statements. This is just to try out how it works, and in Part 3 we will actually do this login logic of a Twitter or just generally a login page. I already made the link for it here, but not the page. So we will build it, but without a database, because it's too complicated for now. Because a lesson about databases is coming soon enough. Don't worry. So let's look into variables and if statements in VS Code. I will close all these extra pages. Yes. Part 2. So, see if, right. Let's first make a variable here. For check 1 equals, well, make this first variable, check variable, we make this value, we make 5. For check 2 is make a string for that one. For check 2 make a string password. So now the if statements, right? We can make CFIF for check 1 greater than 1. Well, is var check 1 bigger than 1? Yes, it is. So this will be yes. Right? Oh. Else? Nope. And we can also do like output here. And let me output for check 1 yes, it's bigger than 1, yeah, like that, for example. And then we can, here we can have no, it's greater than 2, greater than 1. So yeah, so this see if for check 1 greater than 1, yes, it's bigger than 1, and then shows the output. No, it's smaller than 1, shows you the output. Of course, now it will always be correct. But we can change this variable here, the value, and it will be different. Yes, it's bigger than 1. 5. So now we make this variable 1. 1 is not bigger than 1. 2 is bigger than 1, but 1 is not bigger than 1. 1 is equals 1, yes. So we could make that kind of statement too, of course. So now we'll say, no, it's smaller than 1. 1. This is of course not entirely correct, but it is not greater than. So in a way I should really write here, no, it's smaller or equal, or equal to, it's smaller than 1 or equal to 1. So that will work now. You can of course change this setting again to zero, for example. Then it will definitely be smaller. We could also make a else if var check one is one. And see those, yeah. Because now it will not be equal. So now I can remove this statement. So it's smaller than one, and here it will be no. It's equal to one. And then copy that one. There we go. No, it's equal to one. One, yeah. Now that works. We now make it back to 5. No, we make it 0. Then it is smaller, right? Yeah, or 4 for that matter, or 3, you know. No, wait, greater than 1, yeah. So 0 then, because 0 makes it smaller than 1, but it's not equal, so that should then show smaller than 1. No, it's smaller than 1. 0 is smaller than 1. And what I can also do to make it even more dynamic here, for value is 1. Then I could do here, instead of greater than 1, I could greater than for value. That's then the fun of variables in this case again. Equal to. Oh yeah, now I need to now I have to output more stuff. I made it more complicated for myself now. For value. Because I had one there hard coded in my code. Now I need to output that as well. So it still works. So now I can put a var value at 10. And see what it does. 0 is smaller than 10, correct. So now it's entirely dynamic, right? So our var check will be like 5. 5 will be still smaller. That's still smaller, 5 is smaller than 10. Well, 10 is going to be equal. See? No, it's equal to 10. Oh, 20 will be bigger than 10. See? That works fine. You can also do stuff like that with strings. Not in the same way, of course, but almost the same way. So far, check 2 is password. See if for check 2. Oh yeah, and I should also make a var. See if that var value is test. Just to give you an idea, really, what's going on here. Oh, var value 2, not the same. So if var check 2 equals or is the same way, really. It's really up to preference what you want to use, is or equals. I think I use more equals on strings and is on numeric values, but it doesn't really make any difference. He understands he, she. ColdFusion understands. Var check 2 equals var value 2. So if it's correct, the password is correct. If else, the password was incorrect. We can probably also do the output to get the var check 2. Or value 2. Oh. And then we put that as well out there behind it. So that we can see it on the page how it looks like. I'm gonna put a little breaking space in between so we don't get lines conflicting here. Oh. Oops. Here I made a funny mistake. I forgot the hashtags after and before. So now it wants to subtract a numeric value with minus. That doesn't work. My mistake. So, the password was incorrect. Password and test. Password and test do not are not comparing correctly to each other. of course, if I write here, no, password, that was equal, right? So it should be the same. Now it should work. And on the page, oh yeah, because I have there the same issue from before that I copy pasted. That's what you get with copy pasting. If you make one mistake and you copy paste that about 20 places in your code, then you have the mistake everywhere. You can spend a lot of time correcting it all then. So the password is correct. Password equals to password. Yeah. Now you made me wonder, can I then also compare numbers and strings to each other? Well, you probably throw errors there. Var check 2 equals var value, var value 1 basically. What does this do? Output all those variables. Value. So, what does that do? Zop. Nothing. Nothing because it's not true. Because var check 2 says password and it does not equal to 10. So yeah, you can compare numbers to strings. It will just not work out because it's not the same value. It will always look for the value inside of it. You could of course use other functionality, like does password have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 letters. What you can do is count the amount of letters in a string. So we could have, as you said, var check 3 is, how many is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is 8. So then we can check . And by the way, I will first do this one. This one is not working. not equal. So we can also check for once again, var check 3 is 8, so see if len, that's for length, the length of a string, var value, no, var check 2, which is the password, the string password. Length of var check 2 equals or is var check 3. So, yeah, var check 2 or value, var value 2. It's the same value at the moment, but just want to make sure that we use the same stuff. Var value is sort of the value I am checking for, and var the check value is a checking value for. So if the length is equal, then the amount of letters in var check var value 2 equals var check 3. And else the length is not the same. So what we're doing here is checking for, oops, we're checking for the length of the string var value 2, which is password. So nice is if the highlighting, it will show you all the highlighted fields. So var value 2 is password, and the length of the string is like 8 characters. So we're checking if it's 8 characters is equals 8, var check 3. So that should work as well. Oh yeah, I forgot to space it out. So, then the amount of letters in var value 2 is 8. So it was correct. It can also just check for length of a string against a numeric value. This is just some examples of how to work with different if statements and else statements and else if statements. And of course you have to always close your if statements with slash save if. And you can also nest these things. This is what we're gonna do now with login. You first check for the username. If the username is correct, we check for the password, nesting the if inside of an if statement. And if that's all correct, then we can send them to the page. And if it's not, error. So we go to login.cfm. This is a login page. I have not created that one yet, so we will create a new file called login.cfm. Here we'll have basic logic. You'll have to have a form. We could write a form like the way of HTML. You can also use CF form. That is a whole system based on with ColdFusion. You can make forms and groups, and you can make it basically generates all the code for you. But let's just stick with HTML. I will quickly make this page so we have a basic setup. So now I made a basic one from the W3C. I remove some fields for a moment. You have these things usually on a forum, but we are removing them because we're gonna make it very easy. They can all go away. So this is a basic login system. This is a form. The form has a username and has a password and a login button. We click into the login page. Oh, you get a username and password on one line. Okay, that was not ideal. Of course, this was using CSS and I didn't put any CSS in there. So I'll just hack some code in here, make it sort of look alright. So now you can type here your username. It is a password field, so it shows as stars or dots. And the username works just as well. And then I have a login button and it will send it to wherever, which is right now just to the same page because I haven't put any code in there yet. So let's get to that part. First of all, we need a place where we're gonna authenticate this. We're gonna look for if the information is correct. So within lesson 2, I will create yet another file, which is called out.cfm, just for the easy peasy. This is gonna be a ColdFusion document, so I'm not gonna put any HTML code in this right now. What we could do is also add a page for when the user is logged in, just to show how it's done. So logged in here, we will say like welcome logged in user, and that's it. More I don't need there. Of course, this is not protected properly. That was not the point of this tutorial. The tutorial is here about creating some logic and to show how the logic works. So for authentication, we need to create a variable that we can check against. So we have a var our username, which we call smallbringer, and we have a var password, and we make 123. Why not? So incredibly safe password. Yes, I know. I'll see myself out now. And as we're using a form, we're getting to learn some new code here. One moment, I have to go back to the login because we have to say in the action of the form that we go to auth.cfm. That is where we send the data of the form towards. Method is post, so it's a post variable that we will get, and the post variable will end up in here. So we send the form to auth.cfm, and there's this page, and then we're checking for username and our password. So we're gonna make an if statement, cfif, and now we have to take the variable that comes from the form, which is form dot username, I think it is. What is it? Uname. Well, I'm gonna make it username, and this is where I'm gonna make password. Yep. Yeah. Makes more sense, you know, username password. And so we can check for form dot username equals or is, you know, var username. So if this is correct, the username is correct. Here you learn an extra comment. This is a comment and commenting thing. It will escape, it will not show in the code, it will not show in the website that is created, but it is nice to document stuff. Username is correct. That works very well. It is like, because like this, it's HTML and it will show in HTML, and if you make three of those lines, or how you call them, hyphens, I guess. Or is it called dash? Then it will stay into ColdFusion code and it will not get processed to the HTML. Anyhow, username is correct. So now can we check for the password? Forum dot password is var password. See, now I have nested an if statement within another statement. So here the password is also correct. Send the user to the logged in page. So, and that we will also do cf location, that is like a redirecting the user to the new page. URL is logged in. Let's see then. And that is how that works. And then, the password is wrong, we have to send an error. And the same here. If the username is wrong, we have to send an error. And then we can use the variables from before. Cf set error is error message is the password is wrong. And here we say cf set error message is the username is incorrect. And then we can send the person to the login page. And just like error is error message. So let me also go there. Get it advanced now, I guess, maybe. As you can see, now I don't use any CF output, but this is still a variable, and variables have to still have hashtags around them to be executed. Otherwise, this will be just saying error message and not the actual value of error message, which is in this case the password is wrong, and in this case it is the username is wrong. Then that's important. I have to refresh this page. Here's the username, the password. So now we can fill out this field. I wrote down Steven and test login. We're not outputting. But you see here now that I've been sent back to login with an ID token and an error message. I forgot about that whole code, but there's this thing like sending codes. How was it again? Add token, yeah. Add token is false. I don't want to have any tokens, it's not necessary. It can be used, but not right now, which is a bit silly. What I also have to change is I have to actually make a place in login message that is gonna show this error message, right? So cf if is defined. This is a little bit more advanced code, I guess. Is because you cannot check for a variable if it doesn't exist, because it will throw you an error. So the is defined function will see if this variable exists at all. So if is defined url dot error message, because I sent it on a url, then we will display it. Font color is ff0000. It's a bit ugly coding, but we'll do it this way. Font color is red, basically. And luckily there's no CF outputs anywhere around this thing, so it won't throw me an error on that one. But we have to do it in here then now, CF output, and then we do url.errorMessage. Okay, this is not the most safest way, because you could actually hack this stuff. So one should probably use some HTML encoding or something like that, or trimming. But for the heck of trying it out, we will just use it this way right now. But I might change it still before I let you go and check it out, because I have to protect my server, of course. URL.errorMessage. So it should show here a red error message. Oh, I see. Of course, it helps if you use the same variables. It was error, actually, not error message. Error message was the variable that I used to make the error, to fill the error URL code, the query string, yes. To explain that one, this is the query string. Everything behind the website page, question mark, CFID. So the CFID is this value, or this hill value. And then there's a CF token, which is zero. The name of this URL variable called error, and the error is, and is this message. Let's reset my forum by removing all this. So, test again with Steven and test. That should be wrong, because the username was Smilebringer and the password was 123. Login. Now it says here at the top the URL, but it also has now a message here, the username is incorrect. Now the password is wrong, and the username was correct, you see? I'm gonna type in Smilebringer and the password 123. It will send me to the login page, and it will also ask me to store it. No Google, I don't want to store it right now. So welcome logged in user. Still sends me this one. Okay. But logged in, let's see if you can go anyway, because I didn't protect this, of course, now. But that is what it, how it works, really, because Twitter will, after the login page, send you to the Twitter main page, which is probably index.cfm. Or index dot whatever, whatever Twitter uses. But this is a ColdFusion server and a ColdFusion website, so we use logged in.cfm here, and it worked very well. I'll add some extra code to make it look nice, so we can go back to login page. And yeah, that's it for now, I guess. I'll just show you one thing, how to protect your strings against, because of the URL variable, not a good idea. Yes, I found a solution to protect your URL error code. I'll show you here right away. HTML edit, I think. HTML edit code. Edit format. This function, HTML edit format, can go in front of HTML URL.error. If we look at what it says, a string or a variable that contains one replaces special characters in a string with their HTML escaped equivalents. In other words, if you have, for example, someone being funny using the URL error, in other words, type behind the URL error is, and then some JavaScript code to execute on your PC, it will make sure that this code will just appear as code and not as because it gets executed. So we can show this as well. If, for example, someone would write down here a code like script is, for example, script, and then JavaScript back. I can't remember the exact coding anymore, but something like this. It actually will now show invalid, like, even. But it will show the script straight away in here without executing it. And that's why you do that, to protect this kind of thing to happen. If you use the URL variables at all. Most cases we use posts, but this is the one case I would use URL variables. And that's really it for today's tutorial. Be sure to subscribe and click on the bell notification so that you can be up to date when a new video will be live. Also, be sure to check my social media. I'll be there answering questions or just posting content. And I hope to see you in the next video, next tutorial. Bye-bye.